another dimension. A dimension not only of sight and sound, but of mind. A journey into a wondrous land whose boundaries are that of imagination. That's the signpost up ahead. Your next stop, the Twilight Zone. Suspended in time and space for a moment, your introduction to Miss Janet Tyler, who lives in a very private world of darkness. A universe whose dimensions are the size, thickness, length of the swath of bandages that cover her face. In a moment, we'll go into this room. And also in a moment, we'll look under those bandages. Keeping in mind, of course, that we're not to be surprised by what we see. Because this isn't just a hospital. And this patient 307 is not just a woman. This happens to be the Twilight Zone.
We're very hopeful for what this last treatment may have accomplished. There's no telling, of course, until we get the bandages off.
Ever since I was a little girl, people have turned away when they looked at me. I never really wanted to be beautiful, you know? I mean, I never wanted to look like a painting. I never even wanted to be loved, really. I just wanted people not to scream when they looked at me.
Your face, 307?
Indeed I had. If it were mine, I'd bury myself in a grave someplace. Poor thing. Some people want to live no matter what.
I want to be loved. I want to be like everybody. Please, doctor. Please help me.
When you were here before, couldn't look you in the eye. You're just like an angel. Your skin makes me cry. You flow like a feather in a beautiful world. I wish I was special. You're so very special.
I'm a creep.
talk to you about glorious conformity.
This place, and when is it? What kind of world where ugliness is the norm and beauty the deviation from that norm? You want an answer? The answer is, it doesn't make any difference. Because the old saying happens to be true. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Lesson to be learned in the Twilight Zone.